Welcome to Unevolved Gaming. Today we're gonna take a closer look at the Castoroides. The Castoroides is a medium-sized mammal that looks very similar to the modern-day beaver. It has a flat tail for swimming and the body covered in waterproof fur. Its head has powerful jaws with chisel-shaped teeth that seem perfect to chop down trees. The Castoroides appears to live in small groups and build giant beaver dams near or in water. Beaver dams can contain wood, cementing paste, rare flowers, rare mushrooms and silica pearls. Survivors will have to keep in mind that giant beaver dams do not refill. They have to be emptied or destroyed before the Castoroides can build a new one. Like most herbivores, the Castoroides is not aggressive unless provoked or when its dam is disturbed. Giant beavers can be found near or in the island's rivers and ponds. A Castoroides can be killed relatively easy with a decent mount or the use of bolas. It is also possible to walk backwards to avoid damage and kill it with a weapon of choice. However, they will eventually catch up to you. The most important thing is to not go into the water with an aggressive giant beaver. When killed, a Castoroides can be harvested for raw meat, hide and pelt. The Castoroides can be picked up by an Argentavis or Quetzal and dropped in a taming pen on a location of choice. If you don't have access to a flyer or play on PvE, you can use bolas or a large bear trap to stop the Castoroides in its tracks. Survivors will have to keep in mind that a giant beaver's torpor drops very fast, even when trying to knock one out. It is possible to trank them with a small amount of tranquilizer arrows, darts or shocking tranquilizer darts when fired in rapid succession. A Castoroides can be tamed with all kinds of vegetables and berries, however it prefers gallimimus kibble. A giant beaver's torpor drops very fast. Survivors will need a large amount of narcoberries, narcotics or biotoxin to keep the Castoroides unconscious while taming. A saddle to ride the Castoroides can be crafted in the smithy when a player reaches level 61. This saddle can be used as a mobile crafting station where you can craft the same items as in your regular smithy. A tamed Castoroides can be used to farm wood, thatch and berries by pressing the right trigger on your controller when near a tree or bush. The Castoroides can gather wood very efficiently due to their weight reduction. Stone, wood, thatch and fiber placed in its inventory will weigh 50% less than normal. Survivors can take advantage of the wood gathering ability of the Castoroides when it is set to wander in an area with lots of trees, even when not equipped with a saddle. A tamed Castoroides does not make giant beaver dams. It is only possible to make a beaver dam farm with wild beavers that are placed in an area surrounded by walls in their natural habitat. Giant beavers are actually fairly strong animals and can do a lot of damage both on land and in water. Even though they can defend themselves, it is not recommended to use a giant beaver to attack large predators. A Castoroides is surprisingly fast in the water and will not use any oxygen or stamina while swimming. In my opinion, the Castoroides is a very versatile mount. The ability to use the giant beaver as a mobile smithy combined with its weight reduction can be of great value to any survivor or tribe. Giant beaver dams are extremely useful to collect large amounts of cementing paste and wood. Starting and medium advanced survivors can also hunt the Castoroides to gather fur without going to the snow biome. The Castoroides' ability to swim without the use of oxygen or stamina is very useful when gathering resources in the oceans surrounding the island. That concludes our spotlight on the Castoroides. Don't forget to comment, leave a like and subscribe for more ARC spotlights and we will see you in the next episode where we will take a closer look at the equis.